Well, who was Sarran Teelucksingh?
Sarran Teelucksingh had amazing accomplishments throughout his lifetime. He created history in Trinidad and Tobago in so many areas, political, social, and in the economy, that he can truly be acknowledged as the man of firsts.
Parliamentary personalities, a man of firsts, Sarran Teelucksingh, 1889 to 1952.
Way back in 1925, Sarran Teelucksingh scored his first political achievement, being the first person of East Indian descent to be elected to the then newly established Legislative Council or Colonial President of Parliament. In that stage of our democratic political evolution, Sarran stood out as he fought for the lifting of restrictions on voting, quite prohibitive in those days, and insisted on the introduction of adult franchise, which was later granted for the 1946 Legislative Council elections. Let us look at his rise into politics and his impact on parliamentary democracy in Trinidad and Tobago.
Sarran Teelucksingh was the product of the rigid crown colony system of government which dominated the country in the 1920s and onward until the early independence days.
Sarran Teelucksingh was born in California, central Trinidad, on August 2, 1889. His mother, Zilla, was an Indian immigrant and his father a merchant. Although he was born into a Hindu family, Sarran was baptized in the Anglican faith. He gained his early education at the California Government School, and upon the death of his brother, swiftly entered the family business. It was around this time that Teelucksingh began investing in the cinema business. By 1916, he constructed the first cinema in Coover and gradually became known as a pioneer in the business based on the risk he took, establishing cinemas in rural country areas. Between the 1920s and 1940s, Teelucksingh was deemed one of Trinidad's wealthy proprietors, along with Timothy Rudall and Gokul Meir, who held the reins of the cinema industry in Trinidad and Tobago.
He never lost his common touch. It was always there for him. When he came around in Dove Village, when he came around in the Esperanza Estate, in the barracks, he was always welcome. People went up to him and shook his hands, talked to him, and he would listen to them. But in those days, very little could be done for the people of Trinidad and Tobago because we were under the Crown Colony system. We are just another colony, and we had to depend wholly and solely upon the goodness of the governor and, of course, of the colonial office.
Having made his home in Calcutta Settlement, Freeport, with his wife and an expanding family that grew to 5 sons and 2 daughters, Teelucksingh showed a wide range of interests, from the cinematic field to real estate, agriculture to Indian culture. His son, Godfrey, in a recent interview, revealed that his father owned a dry goods store in Coover and also had a business blending rum that was sold to retailers. Sarran's nephew, Henry Teelucksingh, was also a cinema proprietor and film distributor. In the social and cultural spheres, Sarran was one of the major promoters of Indian culture. And then came politics. In 1925, Teelucksingh entered the political arena representing the county of Kearney in the first general elections ever held in Trinidad and Tobago. At the time, the country was still ruled by Britain, and the election was to elect a legislative council governed through a crown colony system of government. Teelucksingh contested and won the Karani seat. However, this victory was contained in a period when only 6% of the total population was qualified to vote. Voting was restricted to only men who had to be both literate in English and possessing considerable real estate.
The legislative period, you know, marked an event where, you know, people in those days went there. We had no radios, we had no broadcast, but people listened, and when the only newspaper at the moment were the Trinidad Guardian, and the people read those voraciously to know how these people spoke at the Legislative Council. They spoke fluent English, they observed proper protocol, and they were well behaved in the Legco.
In the case of candidates, these men also had to be earning a high income in order to be eligible to face the electorate. This meant that the working class and most of the lower and middle classes could not qualify to be candidates and were not even being allowed to vote. Sarran Teelucksingh filled the criteria to be qualified and became the only East Indian to be elected in the 1925 elections. He was later recruited by Captain Arthur Andrew Cipriani to join the Trinidad Working Men's Association, TWA, as vice president in order to mobilize Indian support for the TWA. Cipriani was himself elected in the 1925 polling as a representative of the city of Port of Spain. Together with Timothy Rudall, the three men went on to become formidable leaders in politics during the 1920s and 1930s. As a member of the Legislative Council from 1925 to 1946, Teelucksingh raised many issues which afflicted the population and those in the East Indian community.
He was also very instrumental in advocating the legalizing of Hindu marriages, because he saw how many Hindu families lost their properties because the marriages were not legal, and therefore the children were devoid of all benefits arriving from their parents' hard work.
His contributions on agricultural issues such as cocoa and sugar and other pertinent issues such as education, crime and destitute East Indians are landmarked in Hansard. Beginning in 1925 with his election to the Legislative Council, Teelucksingh raised the question and was the main proponent of establishing an island-wide water supply. In 1930, he again raised the motion of a water supply for the island as recalled in Hansard.
The following resolution stood in the name of Mr. Teelucksingh. Whereas the getting of wholesome drinking water by the residents of the several country districts is well nigh impossible at this season every year, and the germ-laden water causing, as it may, serious epidemics and a consequent loss of lives to these His Majesty's loyal subjects in this island, be it resolved that this government take immediate steps to provide healthy drinking water by carrying out the approved island water supply scheme with the least possible delay prior to any other scheme.
Who could have imagined that this proposed legislation would result in today's present distribution of water nationwide? As an undoubtedly extremely wealthy Indo-Trinidadian, Teelucksingh was of a charitable disposition. He gave his wealth to numerous causes, and due to his link to the people at the grassroots level of society and in agriculture, he worked hard to abolish child labor on the sugar estates and to introduce workmen's compensation, as well as establishing old age pensions. He also wanted the introduction of the full representative government for the colony and an increase in the elected members of the Legislative Council. Despite his many achievements, Teelucksingh's political career was spotlighted by his break with Cipriani in the Legislative Council. The former allies became adversaries when they broke ties over the controversial divorce bill of 1931. During a sitting of the Legislative Council, Cipriani struck Teelucksingh and addressed him in uncomplimentary terms. Cipriani was then suspended from the service of the House for the sitting of December the 14th, 1931.
He had his disagreements with other members of Parliament, especially with Andrew Cipriani, with whom, of course, you heard he had a nice fisticuffs in the House of with the House of Parliament, it is called now. And yet, of course, at the end of the day, they remained friends.
Teelucksingh continued to serve in the Legislative Council until 1946. That year, he contested the general elections, the very first under universal adult suffrage, but failed to capture the Kearney seat.
He was a fighter. In fact, he described himself to my grandfather, with whom he was very friendly, that he was a war horse, and that he was entering the 1946 election, although my grandfather warned him that he may very well lose because of adult franchise.
Clarence Carmichael Abid won this seat with 7,321 votes, while Teelucksingh got 2,117 votes.
But when he championed the cause of adult suffrage, he was in fact championing a cause which will ultimately lead to his defeat. Because although he helped the poor people, although he was a champion of the poor people, his votes came from the wealthy and the rich. And as a result of which, the very adult franchise which he championed became the cause of his defeat in 1946 when it was introduced.
However, this defeat did not prevent Teelucksingh from contesting elections again in 1950. But this time he contested the Kearney South seat. He lost again, with the victory going to Mitra Sininan, who gained 4,681 votes, while Teelucksingh gained a meager 759 votes. At this point in his political career, Teelucksingh demitted political life. Sarran Teelucksingh's public service was outstanding. He served on the Governor's Executive Council, the Education Board, the Central Road Board, the Central Board of Health, the Central Poor Relief Board, the Planning and Housing Commission, the Agricultural Society and Nutrition Committee, and several other bodies. He was also the Vice President of the Centenary Celebration Committee in 1945, which observed the arrival of the first East Indians. He served as the President of the East Indian National Congress from 1915 to 1945, and also as president of the Hindu organization, the Sanatan Dharma Association, from 1932 to 1952.
One of the things that people seem to forget about him, he was also very generous, not only to people in general, but also to the government, because his house in Kuva became the first library in Kuva. And that was a big thing, because we never had a library in Kuva or California. And the government, and he gave it to the government for as a library, part of the house as a library. And the other part of the house was converted as a community. The first community center in Kuva was at Sarran Teelucksingh's house.
In 1946, Sarran Teelucksingh was bestowed the Order of the British Empire, OBE, by King George VI. For his devotion to the social, cultural, and political advancement of the people, and for his public service.
He was awarded the the OBE, which in fact was a very rare honor in those days. It was like getting a knighthood, because at the time in those days, the only knight in Trinidad was the governor. So therefore an OBE was a very, very distinguished order to be awarded.
He also became the recipient of the King's Jubilee and Coronation Medals. Steeped in politics for over 21 years, Teelucksingh continued to help those in need, even when he ceased to serve on the Legislative Council. The fervor of politics and political life identified his character and remained with him to the end of his days.
As I was going away to study, I had to pay my respects to him, being a very close friend of the family. And I had to go all the way on a bicycle to Calcutta Settlement Number 1 in central Trinidad, where he had bought an estate, where he had a house there. And the fantastic thing is that he had taken up a new hobby, and that hobby was woodworking. So I found him at his woodworking place downstairs, playing away at a piece of wood, and then offering me a drink of juice, and then before I left, loading me with a lot of oranges, which I had great difficulty in carrying back to California on my bicycle.
Sarran Teelucksingh died on March the 8th, 1952, just a month after the death of his colleague, Timothy Rudall, who was also a former member of the Legislative Council. Teelucksingh was buried in the family tomb at the St. Andrew's EC Church. His memory and his legacy lives on in the political genes of his descendants and the political history of Trinidad and Tobago.
His life was, as I say, colorful, his language was good, and he had great interest in the people and also in the future of the country. So that is what I could tell you at the moment about the great Sarran Teelucksingh, the man, the first Indian person to get an OBE in Trinidad and Tobago.